Dear students, today we will cover the next topic, that is the design of gears. So first we will cover this spur gears. Now in case of gears, if we analyze, when there is meshing of two gears, that is gear and pinion, we can simply say gear and pinion, so then it means there will be some load which will affect on gear as well as on pinion. So while designing the gears, we will consider this load. So this is important factor from the design point of view. So the different types of loads which are acting on the gear system gears. So first is dynamic tooth load, second is static tooth load, then wear tooth load. Now in this case of dynamic, static and wear, so we will move step by step what is meant by dynamic, static and wear load. Then next is we will cover the design procedure for spur gears. So in case of dynamic tooth load, now here this dynamic tooth load is due to inaccuracies in manufacturing. In industry, when there is manufacturing process of the gears, so then basically in industries, the main important point is tooth profile. So these includes error in tooth spacing, profile lead, etc. So in case of manufacturing the teeth and a gear, total gear, so then there may be some inaccuracies during the manufacturing. And when the gears are in meshing position, meaning they are coming in contact and the gears and gear and pinion is in the departure position, there will be some load which will act on the gears as well as on pinion. So then we simply say that is the dynamic tooth load. Now next term is the transmission error. It is defined as the departure from uniform angular velocity of the gear pair. So if the gear the pair is running in running position, then somehow we have to disconnect the gears, gear and pinion, to somehow there will be sometimes there will be some contact in between the gear and pinion. So if we analyze I want to recall two parameters, gear, what is the difference between the gear and pinion. So basically when we talk about there are two gears in contact, then the smaller number of teeth, the gear having smaller number of teeth, is known as pinion. So some of the effects that produce transmission error. So this transmission error depends upon, number one, inaccuracies produced in the generation of the tooth profile. These include errors in tooth spacing, profile lead and run out. Next number is vibration of the tooth during meshing due to the tooth stiffness. So sometimes there may be some vibrations also. Then magnitude of the pitch line velocity. Then dynamic unbalance of rotating members, if there is some unbalancing of the rotating members. Then wear and permanent deformation of the contacting portion of the teeth. Then gear shaft misalignment and the linear and angular reflection of the shaft. So sometimes there may be some misalignment of the gear shaft, and the linear and angular deflection may also be there in shaft. Then the friction in between the teeth, so then we simply say tooth friction. So now these points these 7 points are which will affect the transmission error, and this transmission error will be the cause of dynamic tooth load during the meshing. Then next is, if we are going to calculate the dynamic load, so here the dynamic load we have we are representing it, and in some books it is also represented by WD. So WD is equal to total dynamic load, which will be the sum of the transmitted steady load due to transmitted torque, and then second is increment load due to dynamic action. तो दिस डब्ल्यू टी वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड. इफ वी रिकॉल देन दिस विल बी बाय द लेविज इक्वेशन. तो देन डब्ल्यू वन डब्ल्यू वाई इज इंक्रीमेंट लोड ड्यू टू द डायनामिक एक्शन. द इंक्रीमेंट लोड डिपेंड्स अपॉन द पिच लाइन वेलोसिटी, द फेस विड्थ एंड द मटेरियल ऑफ द गियर्स, the accuracy of cut and the tangential load. So these are three or four parameters upon which the increment load will depend. So here, according to the Buckingham's equation, the dynamic load will be equal to WT plus WI, which is will be equal to WT plus W is represented by is replaced by this equation represent the total dynamic load. So here in this term, so V is the pitch line velocity. V is the pitch line velocity, and B this is the face width. B is the face width. Then C will be the deformation or dynamic factor in Newton per millimeter. So WT is same this one the steady load due to the transmitted torque. So, now when we will put the values here, then we will obtain the total dynamic load. Now the value of C, factor C, depends upon the error in action. A deformation factor C depends upon the error in action between teeth, the class of cut of gears, the tooth form and the material of the gear. Now this chapter is also given in your book, that is design data book. If we recall design data book, then I want to show here. So in case of design data book, the chapter is 22 chapter. Chapter number is 22, and then the value of deformation factor C. C value of deformation factor C is given here in Newton millimeter. Now this value of C will depend upon the tooth error in action E. So come to the point here, the value of E and value of C, sorry, value of deformation factor C, this will depend upon the tooth factor tooth error in action, that is E. So E may be 0.01, 0.02, 0.04, 0.06 and 0.08. This E will depend upon these two tables. These two tables are also given in your design data book. Here, value of allowable tooth error versus pitch line velocity. Value of maximum allowable tooth error in action versus pitch line velocity or well cut commercial gears. These two tables are taken from the book R.S. Khurme, but your design data book this is also showing these two tables. Now here in this case, from this pitch line velocity, from pitch line velocity given here, so we will pick up the value E accordingly, and then from E, the depending upon the material of the gear and pinion and the system of the tooth formation, then we will pick up the value of deformation factor C. So after putting this value C here, after filling this value C here, then we can simply say we may obtain then when we will put the value C here, then we will be able to calculate the total dynamic load. Then next point, you may also calculate the value of C. You can also calculate the value of C is equal to K E by 1 by E P plus 1 by E G. So here k, this k is given, this is a factor which will depend upon the form of teeth. So these are three forms we already know, and according to these three forms, the value of k will be selected. So EP, this is the modulus of elasticity for the interval of the pinion, and this is the modulus of elasticity for the gear. The one which will have the more number of teeth will be the gear, and lesser number of teeth will be the pinion. Then E is the tooth error action in mm. Now this E also depends upon this, depends upon the pitch line velocity and the class of cut off gears. We have already shown, we have already cleared it in your this one table. The figure is clear from this table. So the value of tooth error E versus the module. So here he is saying, if the module is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, etc., then to first class commercial gear, carefully cut commercial, carefully cut gears or Persian gears. So according to this one, we will select the value of E. We may, if module is given, then you may select the value of E from this table, and if the pitch line velocity is given, you may pick the value of E from this 28.6 table. So here we will put the value of E, then we can calculate the value of C accordingly. Then next point is static tooth load. So the static tooth load, it is also known as beam strength or endurance strength, is obtained by Lewis formula, which we have already calculated. So in case of Lewis formula, we have calculated your this load WT. So this is also known as WS. He is saying this is calculated, may be obtained by the Lewis formula by substituting flexure endurance limit or elastic limit stress in place of permissible working stress. So in case of your Lewis equation, so this term sigma e, here this term is the elastic limit stress, so this was sigma w, that was the permissible working stress. So we are going to replace sigma w by sigma e, then your static tooth load or beam strength of the tooth will be equal to sigma e into b pi m and y. So these parameters we have already covered in your Lewis equation in last lecture. So for safety against tooth breakage, the static load should be greater than the dynamic load. It means WS should always be greater than the dynamic load by some proportions, and it is depending upon the type of loading. For steady load, WS should be greater than or equal to 1.25 WD. For pulsating load, it will be 1.35, and for shock loading, it will be 1.5 into WT, greater than or equal to. So these three terms, these three conditions will be the indication for selecting the value of WS. So now for steel, sigma E may be obtained by using the following relation. If we are going to calculate the sigma E directly from BHN, then we can calculate for steel. For steel, we can calculate 1.75 into BHN will directly give us sigma E, and sigma, we will put the value of sigma E here, then we will be able to calculate WS. So, now here he is saying, during selecting your BHN from the material of the pinion and gear, from the material of pinion and gear, so these are the types of the materials: grey cast iron, semi steel, phosphorus bronze and steel. Then these are the BHN number. So BHN number, this column is also giving us the value of sigma E. So we may also calculate the sigma, we may also pick up the value of sigma E from this table, or you may also calculate for sigma E 1.75 into BHN in case of steel. So because in case of steel, this is 150 and this is 252. Now next point is wear tooth load. The maximum load that gear teeth can carry without premature wear depends upon the radius of the curvature of the tooth profile and on the elasticity and surface fatigue limits of the materials. The maximum load, it means when we are talking about the wear tooth load, then the maximum load which a gear can carry without showing any premature wear is known as the wear tooth load. Here this will depend upon these three factors. Number one is the radius of the curvature of the tooth profile, then elasticity, then the surface fatigue limit of the material. So these three parameters are basis. Here according to Buckingham's equations, this wear tooth load will be equal to dp into b into q into k. So here maximum or limiting load for wear in newtons, keep in mind this is in newton, dp is the pitch circle diameter in mm, b is the face width in mm, and q is the ratio factor. So q can be determined from this relation. If the gears are external gears, then we can simply say 2 into number of teeth on the gears divided by the total the number of gear plus number of pinion, and we may also calculate it from the basis of the velocity ratio 2 into vr by vr plus 1. So when we will put the value of vr, replacing it by tg by tp, vr is equal to tg by tp, so you will be able to get this relation, right? Then k is the load stress factor. So in this equation, k is the load stress factor. It is also known as the material combination in newton per millimeter square. So you may calculate the k then you may calculate the k from this equation. He is saying this load stress factor k depends upon the maximum fatigue limit of the compressive stress, the pressure angle, and the modulus of elasticity of the material of the gears. The load stress factor k will depend upon the maximum fatigue limit of the compressive stress. So one is the maximum fatigue limit, second is the pressure angle, that is phi. One was the compressive stress, second is fatigue limit for the compressive fatigue limit of the compressive stress, then pressure and modulus of elasticity of the material. Now here according to these three parameters, in this case the load stress factor may be calculated by surface endurance limit sigma es square into sin phi by 1.4 into 1 by modulus of elasticity of the pinion plus 1 by modulus of elasticity of the gear. So here the value of sigma es may be obtained from the table. Here the value of the surface endurance limit, this is also given in your design data book by Arun Kumar. So then the value of your sigma es, it will depend upon the material. On the basis of the material, you may also select these values. From these values, you may also select the value of sigma es, or on the basis of BHN n number, you may also select the value of this one. Here he is also indicating one parameter. If you are taking directly from BHN number, then sigma es will be equal to 2.8 into BHN number from this table. Then minus 70 newton per millimeter square. The maximum limiting wear load, this must be greater than the dynamic load. Now keep in mind the maximum limiting wear load should be greater than dynamic load, and we have also covered your static load should be greater than your dynamic load. So it means static load, dynamic load, and then your maximum limiting wear load. So this was how to calculate the wear tooth load. So we have covered wear tooth load, static tooth load, and your dynamic load. Now next we proceed for your causes how the gear tooth will fail. So sometime we see after some rotations, number of rotations, and after some time due to loading, unloading, making the contact and removing the contact, there will be some wear and tear, some fatigue will be there on the gear. And due to these parameters, these reasons, the gear will fail. So we may say which are the main causes. We will here cover which are the main causes of the gear tooth failure. Number one is the bending failure. So every gear tooth acts as a cantilever. We have covered in the last case when we are talking about the Lewis equation. So gear is just as a, we consider it as a cantilever. If the total repetitive dynamic load acting on gear tooth is greater than the beam strength of the gear tooth, meaning dynamic load is greater than the strength of the gear tooth, then the gear tooth will fail in bending. That is, the gear tooth will break. In order to avoid such failure, the module and face width of the gear is adjusted so that the beam strength is greater than the dynamic load. Now, during designing, one parameter should be clear in your mind, that the beam strength of the beam should be greater than the dynamic loading, should be greater than the dynamic loading here. So next point is fitting. So it is the surface fatigue failure which occurs due to many repetitive of hard contact stresses, to many repetitions. So here, what is meant by hard contact stress? So this was the scientist whose total work is on the contact stresses, to contact of elastic bodies, non-elastic bodies, etc. So he says it is the surface fatigue failure which occurs due to many repetitions of the hard contact stresses. So when there will be some the contact, there will be repetition of the contact and a discontact between the two surfaces, then we simply say there will be some surface fatigue. And this contact, surface contact, will be cause of the formation of pits which continue to grow, resulting in the rupture of the tooth surface. So basically, this repetition of the loading and unloading, dynamic loading and unloading on gear and pinion teeth, then there will be some, there may be some pits, and then they will grow, and there may be some rupture in the tooth profile, tooth surface. In order to avoid the pitting, the dynamic load between the gear tooth should be less than the wear strength of the gear tooth. The dynamic load between the gear tooth should be less than the wear strength of the gear tooth. Then scoring. Next, in case of scoring, the excessive heat is generated when there is an excessive surface pressure, high speed or supply of the lubricating fields. So it means when the speed is high and pressure, surface pressure is excess, then we can simply say the supply of lubricant, or there may be some failure of the supply of lubrication, then it is a stick slip phenomena. in which alternate shearing and welding takes place at high spots. It means sometimes we simply say due to excessive surface pressure and due to high speed and due to the lack of continuous, there may be some breakage in the continuous play of the lubricating oil, then during the contact between the teeth of the pinion and gear, rapidly there we may be shearing and welding in between the teeth at some high spots. This type of failure can be avoided by properly designing the parameters such as speed, pressure and proper flow of lubrication, because this type of failure is only depending upon these three parameters: surface pressure, speed and lubricating oil, then supply of lubricating oil. Then we will consider these three parameters in designing to avoid this type of failure, so that the temperature at the rubbing faces is within the permissible limit. Then next is abrasive wear. The foreign particles in the lubricants such as dirt, dust or burr enter between the tooth and damage the form of teeth. So sometimes there may be some foreign particles. So these particles may, in case of dirt or dust etc., they will enter into the lubricating oil, or then they will damage the formation of the tooth. This type of failure can be avoided by providing filter for the lubricating oil or by using high viscosity lubricant oil, which enables the formation of the thicker oil film and hence permits easy passage of such particles without damaging the gear surfaces. Then next point is corrosive wear. In case of corrosion of the tooth surface, so this is mainly due to the presence of corrosive elements such as the additives present in the lubricating oil. So in this case, we should select the lubricating oil in such a way and that the property of the lubricating oil should be the anti-corrosive property. Now we will proceed for the design considerations. So before proceeding the design considerations, I want to recall these slides. Normally in this case we have covered the dynamic load, we have covered the static load, and we have covered the wear tooth load. So in case of designing, we will cover these all parameters numerically. So basically in case of design consideration, the main important parameters in design of the gear, the main parameters we are going to consider here. Number one is the power to be transmitted. In the design of the gear drive, the following data is usually given. So number power will be given, speed of the driving wheel, speed of the driven wheel, or sometime the velocity ratio, and the CD, center to center distance. So these parameters will be given in numerical shape in the problem statement of the problem. Then the following requirements must be considered in the design. Number one, the gear tooth should have sufficient strength so that they will not fail under static loading or dynamic loading during normal running conditions. So it means here we will consider the sufficient strength of the teeth, that they will not fail under the static or dynamic loading. Then the gear should have wear characteristic. Then the use of space and material should be economical. The alignment of the gears and deflection of the shaft must be considered, because they will affect on the performance of the gears. The lubrication of the gears must be satisfactory. Then next is a design procedure. Here in case of design procedure, First of all, we will calculate the permissible tangential tooth load in Newton WT on the basis of power to be transmitted P by V into CS. V is the pitch line velocity, so P is the power to be transmitted and C is the surface factor. N is the speed of the RPM to calculate the V pitch line velocity pi n by 60. Then your service factor, this table is given in your design data book also. So this will be based upon the type of loading. So here these are the types of loads. Then these are the number of hours of running of the teeth. Then the type of the service. Then you can calculate the service factor depending upon for 3 hours, for 8 to 10 hours, or maybe for 24 hours. Then the above values of service factor. The above values of values for the service factor are for enclosed well lubricating gears. In case of non-enclosed and gear lubricated gears, sorry, grease lubricated gears, the value given in the above table must be divided by 0.65 if the lubrication is grease. Then second is apply the Lewis equation and WT. Maybe we may calculate WT by Lewis equation. We have already covered it. So here we will replace this sigma W by sigma naught into CV. The Lewis equation is applied only to the weaker of the two wheels, pinion or gears. When both the pinion and gears are made of the same material, then the pinion is weaker. When the pinion and gear are made of the different material, then the product sigma W into Y or sigma naught into Y is the deciding factor. We will calculate if the material will be different, then we will calculate this product or maybe this product for both cases, and this will be the deciding factor. The Lewis equation is used to the wheel for which this product or this product will be the less. Then we can simply say we will select the value of this one based upon the product of these two parameters. Then the product sigma W into Y. So we have already calculated the sigma W. So in Lewis equation, this was the permissible working stress. The product of permissible working stress into y, this product is known as the strength factor of the gear. The face width B may be taken as 3 PC to 4 PC or 9.5 meter to 12.5 meter for cut to teeth, and 2 PC to 3 PC or maybe 6.5 meter to 9.5 meter for cast. See, we will select the value accordingly. Then third is calculate the dynamic load. We have already covered it. Then in calculating the dynamic load, the value of tangential may be calculated by neglecting the surface factor CS, as WT is equal to power by V. You may also consider the WT is equal to P by V. Find the static tooth load WS based upon the Lewis equation. Then for safety against breakage, WS should be greater than WD. Then finally, find the wear tooth load by using the relation. This one we have already covered. So in this case, this is the total procedure how we are going to calculate the design of a gear, spur gear. Now in numericals, when we will proceed, then all the parameters will be clear to you. How we are going to how we will proceed step by step. What is the first step, then your second step, then third step, fourth step, and your last fifth step. So in next class we will cover some numericals from the design of spur gear. So then after spur gear we will calculate, we will cover the next bevel gear, helical gear, etc. Okay, take care.